morning.
Good morning, everybody. Sorry I'm running late. I'm the only one not watching the clock. Everywhere I walked, from the back deck up, everyone's doing this. But you notice that I don't have a watch. Just want to make that clear. Yes, sir. That's right. We're on God's time. And what a good time it is. So Lois is here, and she had a birthday last week. And my wife and I, on the 18th, we've been married 17 years. That's a miracle with no homicides. I don't know how she does it. Oh, I do too. She has edit. She doesn't hear me at all. And there's somebody else that has a birthday. I just, where'd it go? No, there was a, piece of paper handed to me. Herb.
It's Dave's birthday.
Herb. Herb. I call him Herb because he's almost legalized. Herb. Oh, it's a party, too, on Saturday. Is that your birthday, Saturday, the 28th? That's the same birthday as me. Happy birthday. So let's do a quick happy birthday. No need to sing the anniversary song. Doug hit me with it last week, so...
Happy birthday to you,
Herb and Lois.
Happy birthday to you,
Herb and Lois.
Happy birthday, dear Herb and Lois.
And Pastor Dave.
Happy birthday to you.
All right. I'm kind of liking this. I have beer, but you have to bring your own bottle. Okay. Whoops, did I say that on the microphone? I had somebody ask about our Wednesday night class. Wednesday night is a continuation. It's actually taking what we've learned in the Alpha series and life application of that knowledge. So it's a good study. It's out of a book called The Power to Love. And what we talk about is how we can love others. And really, the only way you can love others is by knowing that all of your needs are already met. So you don't have to freak about your stuff. You're free to have... time and efforts for other people. Monday night is a discussion group on what we teach here. Bob and Wendy, you'll notice Bob and Wendy are noticeably missing today, and so is the kids camper. So there's going to be no kids classes today. They are on a little weekend getaway of their own, and they deserve that too. So as we open up in prayer, if you don't have a bulletin, you can get a bulletin off of one of the offering tables. There's one back here on the back deck and one up there by that window. If you want to purchase food, put an orange cone on your table. That'll alert the waitresses that you're hungry rather than having to bop around to every table. What else do we need to announce? Should I announce it, Brittany? Should I announce it? Listen, Brittany's husband is getting done with his classes in the military training, and on the 9th is her last day here. And then she's got 2 days before he's deployed, and they take off for who knows where. So if you have Brittany waiting on you today, or if you've had Brittany waiting on you in the past, and you want to give her a little blessing for her future, that might be a nice little gesture. Just taking it, ask God what he wants you to do, and bless Brittany for her work here over the last several years. Let's open up with a quick word of prayer, and then we'll start into some music and the message. Father, we just thank you for another day. We thank you for the ability to worship in public. That's not often heard of in most parts of the world, but God, we get to do it here. Bigger than anything, God, we thank you for the lessons that we're learning through your word. We thank you that you're not a condemning, hateful God. You're not a punishing God, but you're a loving, merciful, gracious, accepting, totally understanding God that will never, never, never give up on us. God, as much as we try to understand our relationship with you, it's so much more than we can fathom. But we ask you by your Spirit to enlighten us each day that we would continue to trust you in all things. We ask in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
If you see any new faces in the crowd, let me know. Find out where they got them because I want one. I need a new one.
Yay, me too.
But say hello to somebody with a new face in the crowd. Welcome, Morgan. Glad you made it. All right, onwards and upwards. Page 103 to start, and the rest of them are on the front of your bulletin.
Every
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. And everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior.
Salvation.
is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Drummer.
Yeah.
Good job, here, Bones. Hey, keep the noise down back there.
Na 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 na
Everybody go like this. Ready? This one's for Mary. Good job, girls. What happened to the joy in that song? Where did that go?
No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay. Thank you. Good job. Did I say that out loud? Oh, victory. Oh, victory. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Doesn't make sense, does it? I got the joy, 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 doubt it. You know I have a problem. Why are you bringing that here? It's your fault that I have a problem. See, we go into that whole denial and we aim it at somebody else and we project it on somebody else. But I'm finding that in my life, I need to take responsibility for what's going on here. And if I do, the best person I got to get the answer from is God. God, what's going on here? Why am I so frustrated? Why do I feel so wounded here? Well, what were you... Here's I was struggling with something pretty big that was really doing some damage in my relationship. And I went to John Glenn, the guy who wrote the Alpha series, and I told him about what was going on, and I really wanted an answer. And I told him about this whole situation, and he, in his cowboy way, kind of lifted his hat up, looked me in the eye, and he said, "What is it you think you needed that God hasn't already provided?" And he turned and casually sauntered away in the way he does. He's, you know, and I'm like, I didn't come here for a question. I came for an answer. But little did I know, he actually gave me the answer, because it made me start to think, why was I seeking for something more than God had already provided in my life? Because we're not satisfied. We think we need more than what God has to offer. And if we'll just be patient and realize that the reason that God isn't allowing this is because he has something better, it's really difficult for us to do, isn't it? Lose a job today and see what happens. And you start freaking. But wait a minute, who got you that job in the first place? Who gave you the skills for that job? Who allowed you to be here breathing? Every little thing leads up to that job. Well, I got that job myself. I worked my way through and I didn't go to college and whatever. If you're doing it in your strength, I don't care if that job lasts 50 years. When it fails and you fail yourself, it's still temporary. 50 years is still temporary. Marriage is based on digging in and white-knuckling it. When they fail after 50 years, they're still temporary. God is love, and love keeps no scorecard. So what does that say for us when we mess up? When we mess up, what's going on in our life? Well, my little thing is this. If Jesus put his spirit inside of us to lead us and guide us, and those were his words when he left the disciples, he says, don't worry, another helper, one just like me, is going to come live in you and guide you. When that spirit comes upon you, greater things than I have done will you do. So I often ask this, where is God, you believers? Where is God for you? And some people say, well, God's everywhere. Well, God's in heaven. Where is God for you? What's your personal belief? For me, he's right here. He put his spirit in my heart to lead me and guide me. And if, see, there is a responsibility. If I will allow him to lead and guide me, he's never going to guide me into doing wrong. Because that's not who God is. He's never going to guide me to hate. He's never going to guide me to steal. He's never going to guide me to kill. And that changes the whole thing about the Ten Commandments, doesn't it? Commandment one, when you realize that he's the only God, you shall not steal. It becomes a promise. It's not a command, it's a promise. You shall not steal. When you realize I'm God, you shall not kill. You wouldn't do that. Why would you? But yet, we don't always trust the leadership of God, do we? If we did, we could walk in this earth like Jesus did, in the flesh and without sin. If we only would listen to what God says and say it and only do what God says to do. But we don't. The good news is this. God knows it. He knows that we're fallible. That's why he sent his son, so that the slate could be wiped clean. If you ask anybody or somebody asks you, why do you get to go to heaven? I hear it way too many times. I'm a good guy. You wouldn't believe all the good stuff I've done. I've helped people. I feed the hungry. I feed the homeless. I give money to people. I've put on benefits. I've done this. I've done that. So why are you going to get into heaven? Because even as good as I was, I still had some failures. But thank God that he's forgiven them already, that I'm set free. I'm not going to be held to those. I know, Judgment Day. We talk about judgment. What about Judgment Day? I mentioned it last week. I'm going to mention it again. Big jumbotron up here. Big one. Everybody can see it. Not just here, but everybody on the island. Big Jumbotron, loudspeakers, okay? Every single one of us has at least 5 minutes of our life that we wouldn't want shown. Every single one of us. I don't care if you're 10 years old. Uh-oh. I don't want that up there, right? Every one of us. I got about 10 years of it. But I'm not bragging. But the thing is this. When they play my life, all of it, you with me? All of it, even the stuff that nobody knows except you and God, and I stand before God, what is my position going to be? Oh, my God. How wretched could I have been, right? Wrong. How about this one? Wow, God, you're awesome. You forgave all of that and forgot it? Really? What kind of love is that? No wonder I love you. No wonder I want to do what you want me to do. I don't have to. I don't have to draw little cartoon crayons for mom and dad when I'm little. I love to. I want them to be pleased with me. I want to do what they want me to do. There's a little thing that goes on here. When you understand his forgiveness is total and complete, the next line that we're doing is this. God removes my guilt. He removes it. It's gone. He doesn't heap on more. I've heard people leave church sermons go, well, that was a great sermon, man. I walked out of there feeling like dirt. What? Oh, man. I needed that. I need that good old injection of guilt to know that I was an unworthy, lousy sinner. Saved by grace, though. That's not faith. Matter of fact, I would call it false humility. You know, God, and use me in spite of the slug that you know I am. No, thank you, God, that you set me free. Thank you, God, that even when I mess up tomorrow, you've already made a way for me to move forward in love. It's not faith. Guilt isn't faith. Well, if Christ came to take guilt and shame away, then why would you have guilt? Why would you feel shameful? That's one of those little subtle little lies. Yeah, but look at what you did. Oh, look at what you did. What about what Jesus did? Jesus took it away. Jesus accepted my hurt. He took on my pain. He took on my infirmities. He's the strongest thing I got when I'm the weakest I can be. Why would I not love a God like that? And why would he shoot me when he sent me to the grocery store for milk and I came home with bread? That's not a loving God. You made a mistake. None of us would do that. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God. One sacrifice, and he said these words at the end, "It is finished." It's done. You don't have to fret about it anymore. I have done everything I can do to set you free. What more do you think you need? I know. Hit me with your yeah buts. Yeah, but. Yeah, but Jesus said this. Yeah, but Jesus said that. Yeah. Don't take it out of context. Those yeah buts will get you in trouble if you're taking them out of context. Jesus said that if I don't forgive others, then he can't forgive me. Yeah, he did say that. He said it to the Pharisees who were living in a legalistic mindset, who were trying to tell Jesus how he should live according to his father because they didn't quite understand. And he said, under your law, here's what you're saying. If you don't forgive your brother, God won't forgive you. That's not my father. Here's what it is in the New Testament after Christ forgave us. The only way we can forgive is to be first forgiven. If we've never received forgiveness, how can we give it away? If we've never received acceptance, how can we accept others? Unconditional acceptance. Jesus said these words, love your neighbor the way I loved you. Yeah, but he said it another way. Yes, he did. Don't take it out of context. He said, love your neighbor as you love yourself, right? That was talking to the Pharisees. Guess who they loved? They loved themselves. They lavished themselves with riches. They gave themselves the best clothes. They bought the best chariots or whatever they drove back then. Probably had Rolls Royces. They did roll. What? Gold Royces? Yeah. But they loved themselves, and he was confronting them in their legalistic mindset. You want to know the two important ones? Love the Lord God. Oh, you got that. But love other people the way you love yourself. See what that does for you in life. They couldn't even imagine doing that. What? That's right. What about the tax collector? Lavish him with a gift or two. You got to be crazy. See, don't take it out of context. Matter of fact, when he answered that question, he said, under your law, these are the two big ones. When he talked to the disciples, he said, these are the two big ones. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. Love your neighbor the way I loved you. I accepted you unconditionally. I took you from your family business when you'd already been rejected and said, come follow me. I want to pour my life into you so you can be just like me. Trust me. I can lead you to righteousness. He's a lamp unto your feet. The Holy Spirit is my guide that leads me into all truth. I talk about this a lot on Wednesday nights because the Alpha Series has been a great tool for me to self-examine. And you'll notice at the end of every week's study, we use John Glenn's term, time out for the trip in. When I find myself agitated and frustrated with life and with wife, it's just one of those many things, and with my job and with my situation and with finances and with everything else, when I find myself agitated and frustrated, there's no joy in that. So I stop and I take a time out for the trip in and say, God, what's going on here? See, my emotions are an indicator that something's not right. Your emotions can't be trusted. If you're like me, you fell in love 7 times a week in high school. And Well, that's between you and God. I know I can trust him. You should see what he's done in my life. When I give it to him, he handles it. When I take it from him, I handle it. And that ain't good. That isn't good. If I'm feeling guilty, take it to him. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. If you're struggling and striving and trying to fit into this Christian mold, you're counting on the wrong person. If you're frustrated and angry and trying to make a relationship work on your own, you're counting on the wrong person. If you come running to me for help, the best help I can give you is point you to him. He's got the answers. He knows your wounds. He knows exactly what you need. So let's time out for the trip in. Is it better to be sin conscious or Christ conscious? Here's a little thought. In Romans 6, it says, don't you know you're dead to sin? Why are you worrying about something that you're dead to? Well, am I allowed to do this? Am I allowed to do that? Can I do that? You're so focused on what you can and can't do that you haven't seen what God's already done. Thanks, God. I think next week we're talking about healing, and I've had some issues in this area, and I want to let you know that God's opening up some doors. But I think a lot of the reasons that we don't have healing in our life is because we go, God, if it's your will. You know what? It's always been God's will that we be healed. Why do we question it? Kind of like that whole communion thing I messed up with a couple weeks ago. It's the table's always been open to everybody. You're invited to come and receive forgiveness. Everybody. Well, if you haven't done this and you didn't do that, and you didn't get baptized, and you didn't say these magic words, no. Christ had Judas at the table, honored him with the sop, and said, go about and do what you're called to do. See, we forget that. Am I better off struggling in the weary flesh or allowing Jesus to reveal his grace through me? False humility and true humility, two different things. Wow, God, I had no idea you were so good. Thank you. Oh, God, use me in spite of the slug I am. I don't know how you're going to do it because I'm a piece of dirt. That's not the truth. You are his beloved child in whom he is well pleased. I don't know about you, but I'm God's favorite. Actually, I do know about you. You're God's favorite too, and we forget it. He did this just for you. How awesome is that? He did it all just for you. Can you trust him is the key. Will you follow his leadership of his spirit? As we close up here, I want you to hear a couple of these words. I'm going to go through this. He's mighty to save. I'm just hitting some of the songs here. Everyone needs compassion. I know some of us guys, I don't need that. You know what? There's an old song by Styx. You're fooling yourself and you don't believe it. We all need love. You might be so wounded that you think that the only way you're going to survive is to protect yourself, but it's not the truth. The very thing you've needed is what you've been avoiding. God is mighty to save. He can move mountains. He's conquered the grave. Our God is an awesome God. I can go through this a million times. Mercy and grace he gave us at the cross. And it's my prayer that every move you make, you would make in him. Because that's where you're going to find peace. It's where you're going to find satisfaction. It's where you're going to find joy. Find your victory in him. And today, this one that we're going to do for communion, while Doug and Kat are setting up communion, everybody is invited to the table. If you think you're not worthy, that's the very place you need to be. And say, God, thank you for showing me I'm worthy. Thank you that you're enough. I might not feel adequate, but Christ, with you, I'm enough. I might not feel lovable, but Jesus, show me how lovable I am. Show me how acceptable I am. I need you. I need you to erase all my failures, and I need you to lead me and guide me because you're all I've got. So as you go to communion, you're invited, everyone. Maybe you've never done it before. It's okay. Kat and Doug are not going to bite your head off, I promise. If you need someone to pray with you, I guarantee you they'll do that, and I guarantee it'll be a prayer of love and grace and mercy. don't feel like you're not worthy of it, because it's not about what you've done. It's about what he's done. Accept in the forgiveness. And from this day forward, this song means the world to me. As the deer pants for the water, my soul longs after him. Every day I wake up thirsty for more. He's been so good that why would I ever stop accepting his love? So, Father, as we close this morning, I ask your Spirit to reveal to every individual that you are what makes us worthy, that your forgiveness is what we've needed all along, that your love is what we've longed for and we don't even know it, that your acceptance is perfect, that your forgiveness is complete, and that your Spirit will lead us from this moment, every moment, if we allow your leadership in our lives. Show us where our flaws are. Search our hearts, God, and put out the garbage. We don't need it no more. We want life, and we want life everlasting. God, and you say you're it. So today I turn to you, and tomorrow I turn to you again. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Complete it. He'll be faithful to complete.
can be sure that the Lord has his hand on you, safe and secure. He will never abandon you. You are his treasure, and he finds his pleasure in you. He who began a good work in you
Trying to find joy, trade your sorrows for his joy.
Trade them. Yep.
Got a great redemption plan. Turn him in here.
Yes.
just one word over and over.
La 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 la.
Diddy will do in your heart. Come on.
La 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 la.
Job, Bones. Listen to this one. You know this song, but I changed the words. I think it's effective today. Stop trusting you, trust him. Don't know you belong to me. I let you choose and now you think you've done it all yourself. But can't you see? My love's not based on what you do, so just believe. I will cause you to do worse when you receive. So just allow me to lead you, my child. What you trying? Somebody licks my toes and I lose every direction. Don't you think that time is right for you to find all those things that you thought were proper should be left behind? And can you see which way we should turn together or alone? I already told you what is right and take so long to trust me, my child. What you trying to prove? My spirit lives inside of you, so just believe and then receive. I set you free, and now you're mad. You've had your way. And all the things you thought were good just faded in the gray. And can you see? I can build you up, just give your will to me. When you stop the fight and let your strength be me, just look at me and trust me, my child. What you trying to do? Just see. Just believe. Falling in and out of love with you. He loves you all the time. He ain't giving up. Well, I may not be the greatest man to walk this earth, but I know who is. And I may not amount to what you think is much, but I already do to him. While people keep searching for answers, looking for the light in the dark, I'm standing with the answer, 'cause he's living in my. Well, you might think I'm sounding all too prideful. Let me tell you something true. The very one who lives inside of me right now, he wants to live inside of you. Instead of searching any longer, you can have peace today. You can take hold of the answer, and then you'll be able to. Have a great Sunday. Be safe this week. We'll be back next week. God bless you.